On July 8th, South Korea and the U.S. agreed on the missile defense deployment to counter North Korea's nuclear threats. It's known as THAAD, Terminal High Altitude Area Defense. THAAD is a very powerful advanced system of radar interceptors that can intercept incoming ballistic missiles above the atmosphere. It comes at a critical time after North Korea's foreign ministry recently described sanctions imposed against leader Kim Jong-un as the worst hostility made against the country. North Korea's top official Han Son-rol confirmed that they recently launched a ballistic missile into the sea out of the East Coast.
These kinds of launches are payback for U.S. sanctions, which is nuclear blackmail. The U.S. will pay a terrible price for these sanctions. Americans detained in North Korea will be treated with loss of war and be given many years of hard labor.
The deployment of the THAAD system has caused renewed tensions between the U.S. and South Korea on one side and Russia and China on the other. But political experts here say that this is the time for South Korea to take a stronger stance against North Korea's provocations. China is worried that THAAD can shoot down their missiles. But nuclear experts say this will not happen because China is thousands of miles away from South Korea. The THAAD radar only sees 250 miles.
South Korea needs the THAAD now, even though it may affect the relation with China. China will not protect us from the North's nuclear threats.
Paul Shim was a former lieutenant colonel of North Korea military. He escaped from North Korea in 1997 after hearing God's truth through sermons on the radio.
I read the Bible for the first time. As I read it again and again, I realized that God is alive and He is the truth. I prayed for North Koreans to get to know Jesus Christ. One day, I heard a clear message from God to leave.
Paul Shim is now a pastor in South Korea. He looks after the spiritual life of mostly North Korean Christians and continues to be concerned over the political affairs in the peninsula.
Kim Jong-un proclaims that North Korea will unify the peninsula with the use of nuclear power. In fact, the Revolution for Democracy and the Liberation of the Korean Peninsula is declared as North Korea's duty in the Workers' Party laws. I think the U.S. and South Korean governments should take this ideology of the regime seriously.
Does North Korea really have a strong nuclear defense capacity?
North Korea has made strenuous efforts for more than six decades to become a nuclear state, and that it will continue to do so in the future. They keep saying that they successfully miniaturized missile warheads, made a hydrogen bomb, and will strike the U.S. I don't think that's true for now. But the regime will strive to develop its nuclear capabilities to that level.
Shim added that even under a Donald Trump administration, American troops are likely to stay. He believes they are present not only for South Korea, but for the peace and stability of the region and the world. Lucille Talusan, CBN News, Seoul.